Hi kids, I'm Eric from TerraCycle, and today we're going to talk about how each and every one of us can help the Earth through the three R's. Does anybody know what the three R's are? The three R's are reduce, reuse, and recycle. First, let's start by talking about waste. Does anybody know what waste is? Well, waste is another word for trash or garbage, but waste can also have other meanings. For example, does a tree create garbage? No, but every fall, many trees shed their leaves and they fall to the ground. Are these leaves garbage? No, because they serve a purpose that helps nature. What happens to the piles of leaves that fall from the trees? They break down or decompose and become soil. Soil is necessary for plants to grow, and plants are food for animals, like squirrels. One kind of waste that squirrels and other animals make is poop. But is poop garbage? No, poop is not garbage because poop is very useful for all kinds of bugs and plants. So while all kinds of creatures produce waste, human beings, people, are the only ones that produce garbage. Now, people creating lots of garbage is a pretty new thing. Our grandparents or great-grandparents grew up in a time when people bought and used a lot less and reused and repaired most of the things they did buy. Then in the 1950s, scientists came up with a new kind of material called plastic. More and more companies started packaging things in plastic. And while it seems like making things disposable made our lives a bit easier and more convenient, in reality, it created bigger problems for the planet. Like what to do with all the stuff that we now had to throw away. So, where does all this stuff end up? Well, people have two main ways of dealing with garbage. One is to send it to landfills or garbage dumps that pollute our land and water. The other way is to burn our trash in something called an incinerator, which pollutes the air we breathe. In some cases, the trash even ends up in our oceans and waterways and harms sea creatures and wildlife. We're going to talk about how we can all do our part to prevent this from happening. But first, I'm going to tell you a little bit about TerraCycle and how we got started. This is Tom. And when Tom was in college, he noticed that the school cafeteria would throw out piles and piles of food. Instead of having all this food go to waste, Tom wanted to find a different way to use it. Do you know what loves old food? Worms. Worms take that food waste and create something that plants absolutely love. And that's worm poop. Tom bottled worm poop to sell as fertilizer for plants. And to further reduce waste, he and his friends would gather up used soda bottles to package his new creation. And that is how TerraCycle was born. So let's go back to the three R's. The first R stands for reduce. Reducing means using and buying less stuff. The less we buy, the less we throw away, and the less that pollutes our environment by going to landfills and incinerators. What kind of actions can you take to reduce? Well, before you ask your parents to buy you something like a toy or piece of clothing, think whether it's something that you're only going to be using for a very short period of time and then get bored of, or whether it's something that you'll use and appreciate for a very long time to come. Now let's talk about the second R, reuse. To reuse means to use it over and over again, or even finding new uses for it so you don't have to toss it out as garbage. For example, when you go to the grocery store, you can choose to pack your groceries in a sturdy, reusable bag instead of a paper or plastic bag that you'll only use once. Another type of reuse is upcycling, or using the trash to make something new, like juice pouches turned into backpacks. Now let's talk about the last R of the three R's, which is recycle. After reducing and reusing, the next best thing we can do with garbage is recycle it. When we recycle, we take trash and process it into raw materials that are used to make new products. Sometimes that's an aluminum can turning into brand new aluminum cans. And sometimes that's a chip bag being turned into a garden bed. Now, how can you recycle? You may have a special recycling bin at your home. In that bin, you can usually put cardboard, glass, aluminum cans, and certain plastics. Now, the list of things that can be recycled can be a bit different from place to place. So ask your parents or your teachers to be sure. But not everything can be recycled in your regular home recycling bin. And that's where TerraCycle comes in. We recycle the unrecyclable and have special programs that allow communities and schools to recycle trash like juice pouches, chip bags, toys, and even makeup. We've done all kinds of cool things with trash that's been recycled by schools just like yours, like turning toothpaste tubes into playgrounds and sauce packets into picnic tables, just to name a few things. We even have special contests and fundraising programs that your school can get involved in. So let's quickly recap what we've learned today about the three R's: reduce, reuse, and recycle. When we reduce, we try to buy less or ask for only those things we really need. The next best thing is to reuse and make the most of the things we already have. And then we should recycle to break down the trash into materials that can be used to create new things. If we all do our part to help the planet and encourage our friends and family to do the same, then together we'll have a cleaner and healthier Earth for all of us. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Now go out there and join the many TerraCyclers around the world.